Mr. Giroux. Okay, let's start talking about setting up trig functions for angles even if we don't know them. Unit circle, we got 16 angles, we know all those angles. What about setting up trig functions of angles that we don't know, such as this question? Given a point on the terminal side, of -2, -5, -2, -5, set up all 6 trig functions. Okay, so let's do that. Well, we're talking about angles in standard position, so we're going to be using our sine of theta is y over r, cosine of theta is x over r, and so on. And we're going to draw that angle in standard position. So there we go. And I know -2, -5 is going to be in quadrant 3. The sketch is just going to allow me to have a place to put some numbers. I'm not going to bother trying to get these drawn to scale. So negative x, negative y, that's quadrant 3. So I'm going to draw an angle that is in quadrant 3. And now we're going to set up the reference triangle, and that will allow us to give us to work out our 6 trig functions. So we got a point on the terminal side of -2, -5. So I'm going to also put those negative values along the x and the y movement just to make sure I don't forget those signs when I go to set up my 6 trig functions. Now I've got a right triangle. And it is a reference triangle because it's against the x-axis, and it is marking off the number of degrees between the terminal side and the x-axis. So a little Pythagorean theorem work here. We got 2 squared plus 5 squared. I'm not worrying about the negatives because there really is no such thing as a negative distance. Plus, it's going to get squared away anyway. Equals r squared, and that's going to be 4. Plus 25 equals r squared, so r is going to end up being the square root of 29. And we won't be happy with our square roots in the denominator, so we'll have to rationalize some of our answers as well. Okay, well, the sine of theta is y over r, so it's -5 over the square root of 29, and we'll need to rationalize that. So top and bottom by the square root of 29, and we get -5 square root of 29 over 29. Cosine of theta. Cosine of theta is x over y, so it's -2 over the square root of 29. And when you rationalize that, you'll get -2 square root of 29 over 29. Remember that sine is y over r and x, cosine is x over r. And in quadrant 3, those x and y values are negative. So make sure these answers are both negative as well. The tangent of theta is y over x. So it'll be -5 over -2, or 5/2. And then the reciprocal of sine is cosecant. And the cosecant of theta is going to be this value flipped, so it's going to be negative square root of 29 over 5, and we won't have to rationalize that. The reciprocal of cosine is secant, and that flipped is going to be square root of 29 over 2, and it will be negative because we're still in quadrant 3. And cotangent, well, that's going to be 2/5. So we have evaluated all 6 trig functions in exact form. There's no run on decimals anywhere. We've evaluated and found the exact value of 6 different trig functions without ever actually knowing what this rotation of theta is. We just had to know the point on the terminal side of the standard position angle. Pretty cool, huh? All right, bam, moving on. Let's do another example. Moving on. Hope you're enjoying these videos. If you are, please spread the word. My, as of now, buddy math channel. Trying to I'm really enjoying making these videos. What if I just tell you that the cosine of some particular angle is less than zero, and the cosecant of some particular angle is greater than zero? Could you tell me from just this little bit of information? Now, we're not going to set up the six trig functions because I know nothing about the sides of the triangle. All I know is that cosine is negative and that cosecant is positive. From just this information, can you tell me what quadrant the angle actually is? Again, we're trying to evaluate and work with trig functions without really the aid of a calculator to tell us what the actual angle measured is itself. Well, so where is cosine going to be negative? Well, you put angle measures into a trig function, and out of that trig function, one more time, you get at the sides of the triangle. So the cosine of theta is x over r. Cosecant, that trig function will have an angle measure put into it, and it will also give us the sides of a triangle. Cosecant is a reciprocal of sine, so it is r over y. Now, when we talk about angles in standard position, it is impossible for the radius of a circle to be negative. So we're only concerned with the sign changes of x and y. Well, so where is the x coordinates negative? The x coordinates are negative in quadrant 2 and 3. For cosecant to be positive, the y value must be positive. And what quadrants are your y values positive? Quadrants 1 and quadrants 2. So, if you have an angle whose the cosine of that angle is negative, and the cosecant of that same angle is positive, then where's the overlap? The overlap is going to answer the question, what quadrant is theta actually in? Well, it looks like theta is in quadrant 2. Cool? So we're not evaluating the trig function necessarily, but we are using their values to identify this unknown angle, at least the quadrant that this unknown angle is lying in. All right? So that's how you use trig functions and their signs. Go to those XYR ratios and use them to evaluate what quadrant your angle is actually in. Alrighty then. Now I kind of did this in another video. I want to go from cosine of theta, given that value, and then just find all the other trig functions. So I'm going to say that the cosine of theta is equal to negative 3/5, and that angle theta is in quadrant 2. Okay, well, when I'm given cosine, I'm given an x and an r value. So I'm given two sides of the right triangle, and it's in quadrant 2. So theta looks like this. There's a, rough angle in quadrant 2. And our reference triangle, again, drawn against the x-axis, is going to be always draw your reference angles or reference triangles, same thing, against the x-axis. Cosine is x over r, so negative 3 and 5. Again, just putting that sign there as a placeholder so I don't forget it later. And Pythagorean Theorem, 3 squared plus something squared equals 5 squared. Well, 3 squared plus, I'm ignoring the negative because there's really no such thing as a negative distance. That's a directional sign. Plus y squared equals 5 squared. And when you get done solving that, you're going to find out the y coordinate is 4. Now that we have the three sides of our reference triangle, I can set up any trig function I'd like. And for time purposes, I'm only going to do one of these. Let's say the sine of theta is equal to y, which is 4, over r, which is 5. And in quadrant 2, our y values are positive. So thus, our sine function had better be positive when I'm done setting it up. The tangent function in quadrant 2, the tangent is, the x's are negative and the y's are positive, so the tangent would be negative, and we'll just write that down. The tangent of theta is negative 3/4. Y, no it's not. The tangent is y over x, so it'd be 4/3, negative 4/3. Okay, and in quadrant 2, your y's and your x's have different signs, so your tangent, which is y over x, should have a negative sign. Okay, so that's how you set up. I use little right triangle drawings and show the rotation for all these trig function problems, because that is what we're studying, right triangles and their rotation around these origin or inside of a circle, if I were actually drawing a unit circle. Alrighty then. Are you still awake? Are you with me? Let's go to the next problem. The tangent of theta, I forgot to write that in my notes, is 5/12, and I'm not going to just blatantly tell you what quadrant you're in, but I will say that the sine of theta is, let's say it's negative. Well, my tangent ratio, which is y over x, is positive. So the only way you divide two values that can have different signs, the only way that you can divide y and x and have it be a positive answer is if either both are positive, which happens in quadrant 1, or they're both negative. Negative 5 divided by negative 12 would give you a positive 5/12. So this angle might be in quadrant 3. Now that I'm told that the sine of theta is negative, sine of theta being y over r, where are my y values negative? My y values are negative in quadrants 2. No, they're positive there. They're negative in quadrants 3 and 4. Well, hey, there's my overlap, so that's how I'm going to draw my triangle in my angle in quadrant 3. So just a rough sketch of a standard position angle in quadrant 3, and quick rough sketch of a reference triangle against the x-axis. Reference angles are the number of degrees. It's acute angle. It's number of degrees between the terminal side and the x-axis, so thus a reference triangle. And tangent is y over x, so y over x. Now I'm in quadrant 3, so both the x movement and the y movement are negative. And Pythagorean theorem, 5 squared plus 12 squared equals 169 squared. So the hypotenuse is going to be 13 after you're done working through the Pythagorean formula. Pythagorean formula, okay, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Okay, well now I have the three sides, I can set up any trig function I like. Let's just do one of these because I want to get into one more example before the end of my time period. Let's say I want the sine. Well, the sine of theta is y over r. Cosine of theta is x over r. And let's just, again, re-hit this idea of a reference angle. You know, what if I did rotate only rotate 10 degrees? What would be the reference angle? It'd be 10 degrees. What if I rotated 170 degrees? How many degrees away from the x-axis am I? I'm 10 degrees away from the x-axis, so the reference angle is going to be equal to 10 degrees. What if I rotated negative 20 degrees? What would the reference angle be? Well, it's acute, and it's the number of degrees between the terminal side and the x-axis, so my reference angle would be equal to 20 degrees. Almost a matching number, but a sign change. So make sure that you remember that a reference angle is just the number of degrees between the terminal side and the x-axis. Sometimes you compare it to 0, sometimes you compare it to 180. Sometimes you might compare it to 360 degrees. If you rotate 340 degrees, you're close to the x-axis. I'm running out of time, so I'm getting a little flustered. But if you rotate 340 degrees, your reference angle is going to be 20. And those idea of reference angles and their importance is all over the unit circle. So I'm Mr. Taru. Bam! Thank you very much.
Go do your homework.